achieve one following a visit by the youth member, hundreds of school children get their badges operated for great work in the schools and in the community. And some of the moms and dads, which were children themselves, when Brenda started out back in the 80s. If you don't read Alderman Dinner, celebrate 21 years or more of councillors, former councillors, Barry Smith and Pat Williams, and here in the round room, both of them say, interesting because one of the speakers meetings, and I like that. Thank you. thanks for people rallying around to help in so many ways. I praise also to the council and its staff for helping to keep an easy and comfortable, and help to coordinate, reassure, and continue to offer advice, help, and information. They've been tremendous. It showed in a safe group. I think we've all agreed just to finish. We now need the area to be rebuilt and regenerated, keeping businesses.
That's true. Sadly, Anne lost her seat in 2000, but then came back in 2004 when she was elected in Bidston, which subsequently became Bidston St James Ward, the ward she's represented on this council ever since that time. Anne has sat on several committees in her period on the council, including environmental health, consumer protection, pensions, which she has had a long interest in. She was cabinet member for children for a year, has held a portfolio for improvement in governance and latterly transformation. Anne was deputy leader of the council for 5 years and has been an invaluable support for me during some pretty testing times over the current period. Now, apart from politics, Anne's other passion has been her family. She first met her husband Bill in the Cabin Club in Birkenhead in 1970, as some of you may remember. Lots of people on the progress saying this. In early 1971, Anne bumped into Bill when he was shown a group of pupils in quality grammar where he taught around the university. Anne and Bill shared a glass of milk and romance blossomed. Anne remembers the first time Bill came to her house to take her out. Anne's mother answered the door to be greeted by a tall man with a black eye, which he had sustained playing rugby. Anne's mother immediately shut the door and told her that she couldn't possibly go out with someone who was obviously prone to fighting. But I'm pleased to say that once Anne had explained the circumstances and Mum got to know them, she quickly came out to liking him. Anne got her first job at Liverpool University through a recruitment agency. She was so excited when she was told that she'd got a job as a PA in the theatrical department. She turned up eagerly on Monday morning to find that the agency had made the typing error in the appointment letter, and it was the theoretical physics department. Bill job was actually, she was greeted by a voice-heard professor. Anne went to work at Salford University when the professor transferred there. The university was next to Salford Art Gallery, and Anne remembers one lunchtime visiting the gallery and sitting, eating her little sandwiches while she admired the works of art. The next thing she knew, the famous artist, L.S. Lowry, came to sit next to her. She was so impressed that she bought four Lowry prints, and she tells me that these are probably worth quite a lot to them. The only problem is they've gone missing, and Anne hasn't seen them since, I think, 1982. She hopes that
Comes back in.